Keith!
Hey!
Tony!
I'm gonna send you every day a message.
Tony!
Poor Tony. Dennis said, I'm gonna send you a message every day.
Every day! Yes, sir! Yeah!
How bad do you feel for me? So everybody gets to go home, go back to their spot. But Dennis is coming back to San Diego with me.
Dennis!
Pray for Brandon. I gotta deal with Dennis.
It's a blessing, man.
All right, guys. Mamba out, baby. I'll see y'all, y'all.
I'm gonna miss you guys. Tony! Oh, no. Oh, man. I'm gonna miss you guys. Look who's coming to San Diego also. Keys! So Keys finessed his ball. Oh, sorry, just in case he's watching this. I mean, so Keys actually got the days off because of serious injury that occurred while we were playing basketball. We thought this trip was just gonna end. You know, I was gonna go back to San Diego with Jackie and it was done. But it turns out, Dennis, hey. Keys, hey. Coming to San Diego. Mashallah. Dennis is crazy. It's like 3 o'clock right now. My game is at 6 p.m. I thought we were getting drive-through.
Nah, man, we gotta go down.
Dennis, bro, we're gonna miss my game.
I can't drive, multitask, bro.
Okay, guys, listen. Miss my game. We're still like, oh my.
Hey, we'll make it, don't worry.
My game is today at 6 p.m. Don't ask me why I left Vegas the day of my game. That's because I'm an idiot. If you want to answer for that, it's because I'm an idiot. You guys all remember the basketball videos. Today, the new season starts. My team is back, but there's one problem. Our game is at 6 and it's like 3 p.m. right now and we're still on the way back from Las Vegas and we're still at least a couple hours away.
Ready, full time.
Oh, so how you guys doing?
This was all last second. Like literally even we found out this morning. Up until last night, we had no idea they were both coming to San Diego and now we're on our way. So it's 3:15 right now, okay? Jeez. We're at least a couple hours away. Honestly, I just hope that I'm not late to the game. Why do I always put myself in these situations? Why?
Because you're Brandon.
It would not be a bravadoist trip unless there was something like this going on. And what time did we sleep last night? 5 a.m.? We fell asleep at like 5 a.m. and we woke up at like 8. So we didn't even really get any sleep. Anyways, I'm super excited to be back on the court. For those who don't know, last season, I don't even want to say it because it hurts me, but we did not even make the playoffs. Honestly, it was a bad season. We had an off year. I'm trying not only to get back to the playoffs, but I want to win the championship, and it all starts today. It starts with the first game. Okay, guys, so let's just worry about getting to the game. How about that, Dennis? Dennis, bro, what is this driving? You're going 50 on the freeway. You're worse than Brian.
Seatbelt, safety, baby. Bro, do you remember I said 1 hour and 26 minutes?
Yeah.
It just jumped up to 1 hour and 57 minutes.
Oh, my.
2 hours. And it keeps going up little by little.
Guys, the time estimated to get to our house keeps jumping up. Guys, this is so bad. Hey, Dennis, drive-through. Guys, this isn't funny. Look, it just went up again, Dennis. To top it off, I forgot we moved into a new house. So that house is even farther from the basketball gym. Yeah, this isn't looking too good. This is such a bravadoist thing to do.
Hey, jumping down, 148.
Hey. Oh, it went
147.
Like,
hey.
It went down
146.
1 minute. 2 minutes, it went down.
145.
3 minutes and went down. Yeah, guys, this is such a typical bravadoist thing to do, I swear.
Even the GPS acts like you.
Okay, guys, update. It looks like we are gonna make my game. It's just gonna be really, really close. It's gonna be a really tight schedule, but it does look like we're gonna end up making my game. Shout out to Dennis for stopping and driving like a grandma and finally stepping it up, bro. It was a scary couple hours when you stepped up the driving, but the most important part is we're still alive. Well, actually, some of us are still alive. Damn, what is she thinks a Louis V bag is a pillow? Jeez, this is expensive, bro. God, hopefully she doesn't get no drool on it. We're gonna have to regulate if she gets some drool on this one. Home, sweet home. Finally, I get to see my family. I haven't seen them in so long. It's been like 5 days. I miss them, I swear. Honeys, I'm home. They don't have the doors open for me already, huh? Because the special treatment I get isn't worth shit. Oh my gosh, I can't wait to see Bosley. I love Bosley. I hope he humps me again. Last time I went away for a vacation and came back, he humped me so much.
That's awesome.
Oh, imagine another snake prank.
Honey, I'm
home. Anthony! This is what I wanted to walk into. Mom, did you dye your hair?
Yes.
Really? I noticed.
Oh my god!
Nice shirt, Brian's ready for the game.
Ready for the game.
Alright, hey guys, where's Bosley? Where's Bosley?
Wait, what? Are you kidding me? After 3 days?
Where's the snake?
TA's upstairs.
Nice hair. I noticed my mom's hair right away. I know, me too, mom. Bosley! Bosley. Come here, Bosley. Wait, tell my friends not to come because they're going to take the attention from Bosley. I want it for myself. No. He heard them. Dennis, Yachmara. Come here, Bosley, come. Good boy. Brian, tell them to give me at least 1 minute of alone time with Bosley. Come here, Bosley. Good boy. It was fun. Anthony, didn't I say give me some alone time? Bosley, did you miss me? One kiss. No. Don't wipe your boogers on me. That's not what I'm here for. I'm not a towel, Bosley. I'm a human. Okay. He's just using me to wipe his boogers. I'm over the alone time. Okay, guys, it's time to leave to the game. I'm just happy we made it back in time because if there was just a little bit more traffic, I would have missed the game. Anyways, I'm so excited to go play. I've been waiting for this moment ever since last season ended. Guys, it's been 1 month. I've been itching to get back on the court because if you guys know me, I'm a competitor. I don't like to lose basketball games. So when we missed the playoffs last season, I was so down on myself and I blamed everything on myself. And I was just like itching, like counting the days down until the next season started. So now that game one is here, I'm ready. I do not want to miss the playoffs again. I don't even want to fall anything short of a championship. I want to win the championship. Guys, as a matter of fact, I was so mad about not making the playoffs and I was so upset with myself that I didn't even check in with my friends or I didn't even ask who won the championship. I didn't even want to know who won the championship or what happened in the playoffs. I didn't even check. Still, to this day, to this second, I still don't know who won the championship because I was just so upset. I didn't even want to. Look, I just want to forget about last season and it starts with today. I swear this whole past month has been like a punishment for me. Knowing that I'm sitting at home not playing in the playoffs, it just kept making me feel like it was my fault that my team didn't make the playoffs. I'm telling you, I've been waiting for today. My mom and dad are trying to tell me not to play. They're trying to tell me you're probably not gonna do good because you're so tired and you literally just got home. After I told them last night, I pretty much didn't get any sleep. Like right now I'm running on no sleep. They were like, yeah, no way, don't go play. You should just stay home. My mom was like, you're exhausted. There's no way you could go play a whole basketball game. The way I see it, no excuses. I don't care how tired I am. I don't care how exhausted I am. I don't care how little sleep I got the night before. I'm playing. Are you crazy? There's no way. Oh, just because I didn't get any sleep, I'm going to stay home. No, bro. No excuses. I'm playing and I want to win this game. So mom, dad, I'm sorry, but I'm going to prove you guys wrong. They said, oh, I don't think you should go. You're not really going to do good anyways because you're so tired. You'll see, parents. I'm ready. One whole month, I've been dying to get back. I'm so ready right now. Well, not really because I don't have my shoes on, but still, I'm so ready. There's no way I can lose in front of this cheerleader. What's the cheer?
Go, babe.
Ready?
I'm ready.
Ready?
I'm ready for the swim, but I'm most excited that you're back from Vegas. Only for the camera. No, I'm just kidding.
Guys, Chris, if you guys don't remember, was hurt last season. 21. Guys, I have that stuck in my head. Ball on court. You guys know when they say that? I say A in this video, probably a lot, so I don't know what to tell you. Who or not? Hey! Brendan played basketball yesterday, so I don't know how he's playing right now. They played for like 6 hours. Like, I can barely run for like 2 minutes. It's this too much. 3. Oh. The Splash Brothers are back.
Bookers.
We saw Devin at Summer League.
I saw.
Inshallah. Babe, get that. Good hustle.
Oh, yeah.
Hey.
Yeah.
Woo. Woo. Go, babe. Ay, qué dijo. No, no lo puede decir aquí también.
There you go.
24. We have a timeout. It's 25-24 with 14.2 seconds left. You're doing great, baby. Seconds, 5. Woo! Guys, let's go. That was a good play. That's so weird. Anxiety. I can't speak anymore. First. Oh my god, if it's a buzzer beater situation. I was sitting and now I'm standing. Hell yeah, who scored that? Left. It's 35-35 now. Oh my god. Alvin got hurt. He got hurt. So I don't think he can play anymore. And Chris needs to rest. So we have Marquise over here playing. Go, babe! It's 43-39.
So what happened here, you know, there was a little bit of trash talk going on between that dude and my brother. It was just regular trash talk. You know, the dude was telling Brian, I'm gonna cross you up, I'm gonna cross you over. And then Brian stole the ball. So the dude got mad. And so he fouled Brian, you know, just normal stuff. But then after that, I heard him tell Brian that he's gonna knock him out. I heard him threaten Brian, like, I'm gonna knock you out or whatever. So obviously I got in the middle of that because Brian's my little brother and I'm not gonna sit there and just have someone tell me he's gonna knock him out and not say anything. So I went between them and then I pretty much just told the guy, like, bro, chill out. You're not gonna knock anybody out. Like, if you guys trash talk, that's fine, but don't threaten my brother. Like trash talking about basketball is one thing. Oh, I'm gonna cross you over. Oh, I'm gonna steal the ball from you. Who cares? That's fun. That's funny. But once you threaten to knock somebody out, that's a whole different story. So yes, I got in the middle of that because Brian's my little brother and I'm not having that. You don't need to threaten my little brother. And so things started to get a little chippy from there.
I'm so happy that girlfriends come and record their man too now all of a sudden, but now I'm by myself. Hey, 56 to 49. Woo! Why were you in the game?
Well, I think one of them got hurt. I was like, I can't because I got bands on.
You broke your ankle for Rawatis. Almost broke
22?
Your ankle. Hey, I told you you were going to have 23.
Words from the dude's mouth. He said he's going to knock one of us out.
Calm it, bro. He good.
I ain't got no problem with you, man. And then over here, I went up to the dude after the game because even after the game, when we were trying to shake hands, you know, drop everything and say good game, he was still pretty upset. So I just went up to him and I was like, yo. And he told me, he's like, yo, I don't have a problem with you, bro. You know, I'm cool with you. Good game. And I told him out right back. I was like, I don't have a problem with you either, bro, but that's my little brother. So you can't just threaten him and expect me not to say anything. Blah, blah, blah. We just had a little talk. It's at the end of the day, it's just basketball. I guess trash talking just went a little too far. There's no hard feelings. He told me he doesn't have a problem with me. Whatever, guys. It's just basketball. Things like this happen all the time.
Shout out to Keys right here. This man wasn't even supposed to be in San Diego, let alone play a game. And he comes in and logs some minutes. Oh, shit. You're going to get hit. Oh, my boy. Hey, what's going on, buddy? So what happened there, one of my boys, Alvin, hurt his back. And then Chris is getting old. He can't move anymore. So he was tired. He's like,
I thought it was a joke, man.
And then he's like, hey, Keys, come in. And Keys thought it was a joke. He's laughing. I'm like, bro, if you don't come in, we only have four. Chris, come on, bro. You're getting old. You can't keep up. So Keys came in, logged some minutes.
In some Vans.
Yeah, in some Vans. Oh, and then they didn't let Dennis come in because he's too good. So they don't want. Dennis, hey, they didn't let you play. They had to put Marquise in because you're too good.
Yeah, facts.
Oh, boy, I can't avoid my contract.
He has a contract.
He said he's going to the NBA, so they don't let him play in regular leagues, only the NBA. Shout out to Brian. He hit a bunch of clutch shots. In my opinion, I think we played good. We still got to get a little bigger. I think the other team was getting too many offensive rebounds. We need to box out better. I need to play better. I need to play better. D, my man was cooking me sometimes, and I need to hit my open shots. I think I finished with 22 points. I led the team. I'm just happy for my team. Last season, we didn't even make the playoffs, so we were dying to get back. This first game, shout out to all my teammates, man. Brian, Gilbert, Chris, Alvin, Romson. Shout out to you guys. We won this game because of you, and I'm just happy. Next up,
Marquise.
I'm
saying. He's on your team.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
you know what?
I gave you a whole special shout out by yourself.
That's good.
Hey, Ramona Shelburne here, man. We got Keys. What do you think of the game, bro?
Boxed a big guy out. Was number 24. I don't know what.
Yeah,
his name.
They got a couple.
Something
big guys.
Was a couple big guys. I told him to just box him out and run him. They don't have enough guards with the handles. The guy with the you know what he had on the back of his jersey?
Swavy.
Disrespectful.
This man's name is Swavy Keys, and the other dude had Swavy on his jersey.
But he tried to be slick.
That's his name, bro. Right. You can't. That's like someone else having the name Brandon. You can't. Yeah, we can't do that. I only had 4 points in the first half. Only four. So I finished with 22. That means I scored 18 in the second half. I thought after I only scored 4 in the first half, I'm like, oh great, I'm having a shitty game. I suck at basketball. I need to stop playing. I need to pick a new sport. But then at halftime, I was like, no, this is my sport. I like basketball. And then I scored 18. I don't know.
Wait, so you don't suck at basketball?
No, I still suck at basketball, but somehow I scored 22 points. As long as we win, I say this every video till people get tired of it. I don't care how many points I score as long as we win the game and we won.
What's up, baby? How you doing?
All right. I understand right now. Wait, were you talking to Jack? You said, what's up, baby?
No. Oh, the fans.
Oh, come on, guys.
All the girl fans, what's up, baby? How you doing?
What's up, baby? How you doing? All right. So, you know, Brandon came in the game. I was like, shit, man, he's not impressing me. He should be going crazy. Then out of nowhere, I see a turnaround, you know, hitting his shots, uh-huh. Drawing them fouls, hitting his free throws. My boy Brian was hitting them shots.
Chester? He keeps holding his chest. I don't know.
No, this is my like handle. So then Brian was hitting his shots, you know, carried the team a little too.
Yeah, Brian did good.
And then Marquise came in. Uh-oh. That was end of game. You know, I would have helped out, but you know, I couldn't. Contract regular. I don't want to go over there on camera.
Hey, but really, shout out to all my teammates. Things got a little chippy, but what's new? Every single basketball game we play, it's basketball. People trash talk. Like I said, I don't care a little bit of trash talk. But then when people start to talk about knocking other people out, whatever, that's a whole different story. But there was a lot of trash talk on the court. But I love trash talking. Keese, how much? Look, you might not be able to hear it on camera, but how much trash? Like,
oh yeah, I actually got on the court to hear it this time.
No, I was sitting there. I was like, okay, now I see.
Maybe get a rebound or two.
Yeah, Dennis was about to jump in for whatever.
Dennis is getting ready to jump in. I'm like, bro, we're just trash talking. It's fine, Dennis. We finished the season bad, but we're starting it good. 1 win, 0 losses, and I can't wait till next week. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I'm glad to be bringing the basketball videos back because you guys love those. Oh shit, you're about to get run over. Drop a like if you enjoyed, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys next week for a basketball video. But obviously, I'll see you guys tomorrow for another boring Bro Waters video. Peace out, guys. We said good game, but at the end of the day, I just told him, bro, like, that's my little brother. So, of course, I had to say something, but it's basketball, and we're going to play them again. Like I said, no hard feelings. And he actually told me that his son watches my videos. And I told him, I was like, hey, bring your son out next time we play you guys so he can watch the game. So, there's, like I said, yeah, things got chippy. Things got a little dirty. Some words were said. But at the end of the game, I went up to go see what the problem was. And after that talk, everything's cool. There's no hard feelings.